it's close, Gucci. To King Yoda's Queen, come to cheek. And Merry Christmas. Today is Christmas Eve. By the time this video comes out, it's going to be Christmas Eve or Christmas. Do not know. So today, we will be making cute little hot glue Christmas erasers. For this project, you will need a cup of water, a plate, or kind of like a thing that you can paint on, hot glue, a hot glue gun or super hot glue gun, a mold or a thing that has mold, but we had from a plastic, so we cut it out. A paintbrush, right here. Paper towel, trash can, hot glue sticks, scissors, and some paint. Please go down below, like, subscribe, comment down below what we should do next, and let's get on with the video. First, you have to get your mold. Get your paintbrush, so get your paintbrush, dip it in the water, and keep going back and forth. Oh gosh. Make sure you clean off your paintbrush if it hasn't been used, because you don't want paint on it. So you get your paintbrush full of water and you keep dabbing it till you have the bottom of the whole thing covered. Gosh, this thing's not coming out correctly. It should look something about like this. Once we have that done, you kind of just go around the sides. Then you grab the hot glue gun. Be careful. Do not do this without adult supervision. You start filling it up. I need a hot glue stick. You want to do it over the plate so it doesn't get everywhere. And we'll see when I filled it up with hot glue.
Have your mold filled with hot glue. Should look about something like this. Then you let it cool and you get the end of your paintbrush and kind of go over the edges, because you don't want stuff on the edges of the mold, and see when this has cooled. It'll take about 5 to 10 minutes. If you want to speed up the process, you can put it in a fridge or freezer. So see if your mold ready, you cut or pop. If you have a plastic mold, we'll cut out around the hot glue. If you don't, it's okay. So once you have it, ready to be peeled, you just start peeling it. It might take a while, so let's put this on a time lapse. That'll be easier. You have it popped out, cut it so it's kind of round and circular and not such a ragged edge. Once you have that done, you can unplug your hot glue gun, get a plate, and say I'm gonna paint this red, green, and white, so I'll get green, red, and since we don't have we'll use this white right here. Okay, so how to get it kind of like a watercolor is one part paint. You want to add a drop or two because you don't want to have a lot. Then 2 parts water. So you kind of did what you did earlier in the beginning, just adding, or you can kind of go over the edge and go. Okay, that's a lot of water. Then you just start mixing the water with the paint to kind of like a pigmented water. Watercolors too, there's not enough pigment, so you have to do this, or you can just do watercolor if you want it to look like it's not
there. You have it out of the bowl. You trim the edges so it's not so jagged. So, if you want to leave it like, if you want to leave it just plain, you can do that. But if you want to get it colored, you mix 1 part paint, add like a drop or two, not too much or too little. It's up to you. I just want to use a lot because it's not a big eraser. Then you get a cup of water and you add little drops. Do not pour the cup because I did that earlier and we failed. This is like take 2 or 3. So it looks something like this. Then once you have it like that, you start mixing it together. You want to make sure it's mixed evenly so you don't have a part that's just water or just paint. So once you have it, you kind of roll your brush into the paper towel, add a little water onto it, clean it off, then get a little tiny little dab of the paint. Then you get your
little erase through that made out of hot glue. And ours has a little indent, so I'll just paint a little bit. So can we get a zoom in on this? A little zoom in. Then just add a little bit of paint. It might look a lot clearer because it is. But once it dries, it'll become more pigmented. So then, once you have one color down, you have to let your paper soak in because the water's really pigmented. Every time. You have a little green. I'm just gonna dump it this time. Please tell me I do not mess this up. Okay, it's good. Then you mix it again. Then you do the same thing. I'll see you later when I'm done.
After seeing painted, you can mine dry already, so I'm gonna put it off to the side after I show you. So that's the final product. Thank you guys so much for watching. Before you go, my favorite thing about painting is mixing all the colors up and adding water to it. I don't know. So see you guys soon. Have a merry, 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 merry Christmas. Open all your ears, have a great time, and have a happy Hanukkah too if you celebrate Hanukkah. And peace out.